Welcome to a review on how to multiply and divide integers. We will be using the formal rules to determine the given products and quotients. When multiplying or dividing two integers with the same sign, the result is always positive. And when multiplying or dividing two integers with different signs, the result is always negative. Looking at the first example, we have positive 8 divided by positive 1. The two integers have the same sign. The quotient is positive 8. Next, we have negative 8 divided by positive 1. The two integers have different signs. This quotient is negative 8. Next, we have negative 8 divided by negative 8. The two integers have the same sign. The quotient is positive 1. Next, we have negative 8 divided by positive 8. The two integers have different signs. The quotient is negative 1. This is followed by positive 8 divided by negative 8. Again, the two integers have different signs. The quotient is also negative 1. And here we have 8 divided by 8. Two integers have the same sign. The quotient is positive 1. Next, we have a quotient involving 0. Because 0 is not positive or negative, we can't use the formal rules for multiplying or dividing integers. One way to interpret 0 divided by 8 is to take 0 and divide it into 8 equally sized parts or groups. Either way, we still have 0. 0 divided by 8 equals 0. Another way to think of this is to ask how many 8s there are in 0. Because there are 0 8s in 0, the quotient is 0. Next, we have 8 times 1, which equals 8. Next, we have 0 times 8. When multiplying, whenever one of the factors is equal to 0, the product is always 0. We can also think of this as 0 copies of 8, which equals 0. Next, we have negative 8 times 0. Because we're multiplying by 0, the product is 0. Next, we have negative 8 divided by negative 1. The two integers have the same sign. The quotient is positive 8. And then finally, we have negative 8 divided by 0, which is asking us to take negative 8 and divide it into 0 equally sized parts or groups, which is not possible because we have to have at least one group of negative 8. This is one explanation as to why division by 0 is undefined, and therefore we enter DNE. Another way to explain why the quotient is undefined is to take a look at the corresponding multiplication problem. For example, if we have 6 divided by 2 equals 3, the corresponding product is 3 times 2 equals 6. Notice to form the corresponding product, we use the quotient in the reverse order. So for this quotient, we're looking for some value or some number times 0 that's equal to negative 8. And there's no number times 0 equal to negative 8, which is another reason why division by 0 is undefined. I hope you found this helpful.